and perfect it. Then they come and teach that don't break anyone's heart, but the heart is the seat of faith, the seat. And that heart that's filled with love, that love is equal to iman. No love, no iman. So Prophet was teaching his companions, show me how much love you have. They bring this, they had something, a big battle, and we have to collect everything. Let's see what everybody's faith is. Each one bringing according to their faith. Until the great companions brought half of everything. So alhamdulillah, we brought half of everything. And then Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Qaddas Allahu Sirruh, brought everything. This is for us the understanding that the other companion, Prophet asked him that your faith is half. He brought everything he has for me and he brought half of what you have, your faith is half of what he has. And the hadith is long, it goes into detail, but for us the gist of that, that the Prophet is teaching for us, is that your faith won't be complete until you love me more than you love yourself. Because he had asked him, what did you leave for your family? Like, I love you and I love myself. And from Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, I left for them, Ya Sayyidi, Allah and His Rasul. Nothing else. Everything I have here at your feet. So then the spiritual paths, the turuqs, they come and begin to teach that for that heart to open, it has to love the prophetic reality, Sayyidina Muhammad more than it loves itself. And through that love and through that ish becomes the oceans of faith. And everything is attacking that heart. So then the opposite of love is anger. So Prophet would sit, as soon as somebody would become angry, Prophet would walk away. So where are you going, Sayyidi Ya Rasulullah? Because as soon as anger comes, shaitan is present. In adab and anger, you can enter into kuf and disbelief. And instantly, but then a rage of anger, you could kill someone. Means immediately within the heart shaitan hits the rage and the fire that is brewing and you've left faith. So then they begin to teach, the focus should be the heart. Make it to be Baytullah, make it to be love and filled with the love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when that love and the heart becomes from the ashiqeen, they are the lovers of the prophetic reality, they love all the Prophet ﷺ, they make no distinction. They take every jewel and every precious word that they were teaching and they exemplify that character and they harm nothing. They walk a path of consciousness and love for Allah's creation. They love whom Allah loves and they hate whom Allah hates. And the only one whom Allah hates is shaitan. So they are fiercely against shayateen, but insan is a noble creation. And they begin to teach that fix the heart, purify your heart, focus on your heart. And the whole science of tafakkur and contemplation, and every night muhasaba and accounting. That all your amal may mean nothing in Allah's presence. So with tafakkur and contemplation, muhasaba, our accounting, is then we're trained every night, go home when everybody's asleep and you're not distracted by anything because daytime made for commerce, nighttime made for Allah. That the internet is off, everybody's off, the electromagnetic field, everybody's sleeping, qiyam al-layl. Wake up 2 hours before Fajr and then sit, Ya Rabbi, what is my account for today? And take a hisab of the self, who did I harm? Who did I hurt?
what bad things that I say, what bad actions that I do. And most people run away and never do that again. They don't want to know the hisab. They rather live within ignorance and think that their amal is good and Allah accepts that amal and their actions. And Mawlana describes it's like spiritual poverty. You may think your amal is so wonderful, so great, that like an inventory you think it's worth $5 million and Allah opens the chest and say, it's all shattered. It's all filled with bad characteristic and bad actions. What I needed from your salah if you went and harmed people? What did I need from your zakah if you chased it with a bad word and bad actions? What did I need anything from you and the character was bad? But don't you know that the heart is my home? And you go around breaking people's hearts, means intentionally inflicting harm on people so that their hearts will be shattered. Imagine you shatter the heart of one of Allah's awliyaullah, that Allah very present within that heart, Prophet very present within that heart. So you live a life, be cautious, be careful. You walk upon eggshells. Ittaqullah wa'alimukumullah. Allah says you have to have a taqwa and a consciousness. The taqwa is not beating up people and thinking that your praying is great. The taqwa is beat yourself up and know that everybody else is great. Ya Rabbi, you made Jahannam for me. Everybody else is good, I have nothing to do with them. I'm not their judge, I'm not their jury, and most definitely I'm not their executioner. But your Jahannam is waiting for me. What am I going to answer you with these actions? What am I going to answer you with what my heart has done, what my tongue has done, what I have inflicted upon people? Allah can forgive everything except the broken heart. Allah's just. How can He forgive something that's not in His hands to forgive? Allah forgive you for everything that you did against Him. It was Ghafoor Raheem. You didn't pray, come, okay, I forgive you maybe. You didn't pay, okay, maybe I forgive you. Everything within Allah's jurisdiction, He forgives. But to harm someone else, what Allah has to forgive? He said, you wait right here. Let's bring him. Come. This one inflicted harm upon you? Ya Rabbi. This one broke your heart? Ya Rabbi. This one hurt you? Ya Rabbi. Nobody going anywhere. You have to then be asked, do you forgive? No, Ya Rabbi, don't forgive. He inflicted tremendous harm and difficulty. Now there are people burning other people, believers. They pass judgment on what their level of belief is and they torch them like their kabbalahs, burn bodies. They tortured them before death. And you think that one going to be in front of Allah and say, okay, Ya Rabbi, whatever, I forgive them? No! They inflicted tremendous harm upon me. I want my justice, Ya Rabbi. So then awliyaullah come into our lives and say, you don't want to meet your Lord like that. You don't want to go around inflicting difficulty upon people, harming, harassing. And then what are you going to answer to all these people? So then, those people have no taqwa, they're jahal. They run in the fire and they live in the fire and they don't care. Ahli taqwa, the people of consciousness, every night they're crying that I really believe in you and I know you're going to judge me and what am I going to answer to you? That'll be let tomorrow be a better day, I'm sorry for what I did. I will go and find those people and try to make an amends. Try to ask for forgiveness that I harmed you, that I hurt you, that I insulted you. And that tomorrow to be a better day, Ya Rabbi. Give control over my tongue, give control over my hands. There are people who beat their family and then they go to pray. What the heck is that? Who going to pray from that? That person going to come and tell Allah, I hated your religion. All I saw from it was this person beating me. They torture in some countries with holy sounds. What they're going to answer to these people? Allah just, let's call them and see what they did. Ba'al haqa'iq and the people of realities, their masters are sincere, and the sincere masters, they have an understanding of what punishments are ahead of them. When they make their tafakkur, make their contemplation, they pass through the azab of the grave. That when you begin your first levels of tafakkur and contemplation, what do you begin to contemplate? As soon as you begin to train with the teacher on tafakkur, you begin to close your eyes and meditate, and then you start to see all the horrible things that your eyes witnessed all your life and every day. Every movie, every picture, every internet site, every song that you heard of cursing, yelling, screaming. And all your meditation is just going through these images. And Allah says, don't you see that your eyes are the digital recorder and that your ears are a digital recorder? And I don't need anybody to come and say what you did, I'm just going to play your tape for you and in front of whoever has to be in that room. Most definitely in the presence of Prophet ﷺ. It's a courtroom. And the Nabi ﷺ must be there, the Salihin must be there. And they play this recording, this is what your eyes saw, this is what your lips said, this is what your hands did, this is where your feet went. Can you say, no, that wasn't my eyes? Allah says, I'm going to make them testify for you. And I'm going to, first thing I'm going to seal up is your mouth. Because your mouth talk is cheap, you talk a lot. What are your hands going to tell me? Oh Ya Rabbi, I beat and slap like you can't imagine. Don't listen to his mouth. His feet went dancing and all sorts of crazy moves. Everything going to testify. So real salihin who are inheriting, all night long meditate, contemplate and begin to cry. What am I going to do? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? And Allah begin to open a vision. This is your qabr and this is the fire that you face. What are you going to do in your qabr? And say, Ya Rabbi, let me go now into that grave and begin to make salawat on Prophet. Let me to purify that site. And many salihin from past, they would dig a grave in front of their house. Read about them. Pious people, they dig a grave in front of their house and say, Ya Rabbi, I'm going to go do all my ibadah inside that grave. And they would go into the grave right in the front of their door. These were in countries you could do that. Here you try to do that, they arrest you. Hey, it's a fire pit, we're going to make a barbecue. They make the grave and every day prayed in it, did all their salat in it, read all their Qur'an in it, made all their tafakkur in it, then made all their siyam and their fasting in it. Ya Rabbi, let my qabr to be filled with light. Don't let fire to come. It's these pious people, extremely pious. And now we are in a drunken state, never thinking of what we are doing and what is going to be the outcome. And then they begin to teach, meditate, contemplate, take an account of yourself. At the end of the evening think that, what did I do? Who did I harm? Where did I go? What did I say? And write it. And say, Ya Rabbi, I'm taking an accounting now. Fix the people that I've harmed and pray that tomorrow be a better day. And you do that 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days. Either you quit and run away, or you begin to work upon yourself. Because unless you're mentally insane, because insane is that you do the same thing, always expecting a different outcome. If you look at your book in 7 days and you're doing the same thing, then you must be insane, because you don't want to change it. Those that are not insane, then they look, say, Ya Rabbi, and begin to cry, how come it doesn't change? And then the shuyukhs, because you have to know yourself. When you know yourself, you know your Lord. And the shuyukhs begin to teach you. You have a hard time controlling your mouth, inherit from Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, put a stone inside your mouth. Because when you're working on a characteristic, there has to be a zikr and an action to control that. You can't control the tongue if after it hurts somebody. And then, oh, now what am I gonna do? So they say, no, put a rock in your mouth. Big one, not a small one, so you choke to death. So you're gonna come back, shaykh, you swallow the rock. Not a big one. So you actually have to take it out. As soon as the action of taking the rock out, you immediately combated the ego. That, do I really need to take this out and answer this person or say something to this person? Most likely no, put the rock back and say, ahlan, and walk away. And then the path of spirituality becomes real. Working on the characteristic, the action to control the bad character, the zikr that's been given to tame the wildness and bring the fire of anger down, bring the fire of pride down, bring the fire down that shaitan is moving within the body based on that fire. We pray that, and some people get the rock but just keep it within their purse or wallet.
I'm looking for it.
Then rock has to be in the mouth, and that has to control what the tongue is saying. InshaAllah, we understand from their teachings, always reminder to myself, there are oceans of medicines and remedies for bad characteristics, limitless. But the willingness of students, no more. There are very few and far between that are willing to combat themselves, fight themselves, struggle against themselves, more interested in struggling against others. We pray that Allah open our hearts to understand, and that we move towards taking away our bad characteristics, so that these lights and this love and this beauty can begin to shine through the heart. When it shines through the heart, the face will be lit with Divine light. And they become nurani. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wassalamu ala al-mursaleen.